and I really appreciate, because he's going to help me here with my slides. And I have slides, yes, guess what? Because we're going to go into a bit more depth, and I coordinated with Rob to go a bit in more depth into the concept that he attacked or he presented to you. And I want, first of all, to express my gratitude to Rob for having met him, because it's true. Yeah, feeling lonely in this world is easy, but he found me and we found each other, and I'm here and I'm here with you, and I look forward to share much more. And indeed, it is important to start with the individual. And tonight we will have a ceremony where we will have an opportunity to go inwards, and I have the turtle here on my chest, all the way down and all the way up, like the integrals are saying, and feel who we really are and how we are connected to each other. I think it's very important to remember that, because Machiavelli, maybe, not necessarily Machiavelli, but those who implemented certain concepts not correctly, made us somehow forget that. So to start with the beginning, yes, the talk, Moloch, many of us know what it is, but when I came here, many people, including the Uber drivers and so on and so forth, they were asking me, why are you here? I said, for a conference. What is it about? And I said, it is about fuck the government. And the question is, I mean, why? Why, yeah? Why? Why is because of this? And he knows exactly, without me telling him when to change the slides. This is why, yeah? These are the symptoms of the meta-crisis, where we got, but how we got there, yes? So this is what we see. So what we see is the health system is still sick, the education system is unable to learn, and so on and so forth, and we know that. This is from a book by Otto Scharmer, professor at MIT, and we need to upgrade society's operating system, yes, from where we are now with the issues, finite resources versus infinite growth, and so on and so forth, to a much better world. But and this will be much better in on the recording, I'm promised, what you see here. We cannot see, but these are all the conundrums of the meta-crisis. So... Okay, so let's see which are the generator functions. Many of you maybe know about the meta-crisis, like the rival roles dynamics, which Rob mentioned, yes, in which we, instead of cooperating, we are fighting with each other for very scarce resources, when we think that they are scarce. But why are they scarce? Because we think that we are separate from nature. So it is, we look at nature as a commodity instead of looking at us as part of nature, that we are actually, we should play together with nature. And okay, so how can we change that? Rob tackled it a bit. It's not gonna be chaos, although we are all anarchists here. I can, you know, we can define ourselves as anarchists, but it's not gonna be chaos. That's not really the solution. Of course, we don't want it to be even a stronger Moloch, a top-down dictatorship to put order into chaos. But this global coordination, how can we achieve it, actually? And there are ways. Technology can give an answer, and SingularityNet is working on that. Obviously, Singularity is saying it. How? There are a few, and of course, blockchain, and we know about all this stuff with DAOs. But... there are some questions which we need to answer. And I think I will just give you an idea, because, of course, I cannot go in depth. And I suggest that we go in depth on the unconference day, when I will propose a special session, going deeper into the network effects and how can we actually model that. No, just... So the questions which we need to answer is, how can we use the digital environment to increase people's capabilities, what he was mentioning? How do we implement architectures of participation? How do we achieve effects with resources which we cannot control? And in other words, that's how I coined organic governance. There is a big problem, yes, because in the world, the reputation of such technologies, like, for example, the Web3, is not very good, and that is because the attention is being hijacked. Yeah, the attention is being hijacked towards the negatives. Why? Because it's not good for the current system. So Moloch wants us to believe that actually these technologies are really bad, that the crypto people are bad, and wow, DAOs, they are threatening them, their system. And only 5% of goodness is in the DAOs that are pioneering governance. So we have to change, we have to shift this perception. And that's why, I mean, obviously we know it, yes. The only thing is that we also need to transmit that to others in the world. What I want to show you now is how we look at the world, how we actually should look at the world, not in a linear way, and how is the meta crisis happening, and how can we actually model it with networks. So the world is a system of systems where we have subsystems like, you know, continents, so the world, continents, countries, they are all, you know, more or less, they should work together, cooperate, trade, and so on and so forth. So just keep this in mind. Networks of complex systems. And guess what? Scientists, well, I can say like me, that's why I have those titles, have detangled those networks of complex systems mathematically. Yes, so we can actually, so again, don't forget, the world is a network of complex systems. And even, guess what? The risks are a complex network. And then we can detangle them and point to them, and this is the science of networks. The science of networks says a few things, and I can go with you. I have only 3 slides for this quick immersion into the science of networks, just with the main parameters. So what does it mean? It relates network topology to the network properties, such as resilient or vulnerability, or the weakest link, or where will my system crash and collapse. And in that way, we can predict what Rob was talking about. We can predict through flows that go through links of the network, we can predict if a crisis will occur. We can predict the effect of a policy before it is applied. So it's very important, one thing in the network, and that is bringing back, I don't know how many of you, me and Rob, we have white hair, so have heard of Mitch Kapoor and his architecture, architecture is politics and politics is architecture. Wait, I'll buy you a drink. So and we have to talk about that. And that's why topology is very important for the dynamic of the network. Yes. So the idea is, and we can go deeper on the last day, that we can form a connectivity matrix which maps desired output properties like robustness and its input attributes like degree distributions, resource exchange across links, the flows, and so on and so forth. So we can control actually how the flows go through the network so it does not collapse. And we can do that by tuning the input attributes to maximize robustness. Anyway, I think enough theory here. And robustness is achieved by a collection of protocols, and we know about protocols, the crypto people, specifying control strategies for managing the flow of data, people, packets, material, depending, energy, whatever is flowing through that network, which create barriers to cascading failure. So speaking of the meta crisis, we have ways to model it, but we also have ways to model societies, yes, which are also networks of individual agents. And you know, this is nothing new, because in biology, genes are behaving in the same way. They are coding for sensors, actuators, and the complex regulatory networks that control them, conferring the cell robustness. That's how we actually function. That's why we don't get sick, that's why how immunity is functioning and so on. So we want to transfer that immunity to society, especially to our society of regions, degens, and the new world which we want to create, so we stay resilient in the face of the Moloch adversity. So in the end, we win this fight, because I think it will be, it is a fight. Okay. So, and now just very quickly, just to let you know, this is also a kind of network, and this is the hierarchy. The hierarchy has a property, and the biggest problem with Moloch is that what Moloch is trying to do is to control a complex system, which is the world, as I presented to you, with a very linear, complicated structure, which is this, which is actually this top-down hierarchy. And it is failing, as we know, yes, as we see. This is already mathematically proven. That's what I have there. So So the idea is, yeah, the hierarchical organization is the main culprit here. And this authoritarian governance, which is actually, and Rob alluded to that, in which stability is guarded by stiff coordination systems, where risk taking is punished, when initiative is punished. So the incentives are really all pitting us against each other. It's not really something which can, yeah. So anyway, this is an image which you can see later. So the idea is that nobody knows and understands how, if you can go back to that image, because nobody knows and understands where is the cause of a failure. This is an automatic back scratcher, but probably you cannot see it very well here. But the idea is we don't understand where are the failures because of how these governance systems are designed. But this is done with a purpose. So let's come back to the organic governance. So the idea is to the paradigm shift from linear to bottom-up designed by emergence. And I have a paper about that. Don't worry if you don't understand what I'm telling you now. But I will go in more depth on this. So if you Google my name and design by emergence, you will find that. But I will go in more depth. And so the main idea here is that different kinds of networks can respond to different kinds of problems. And as Rob was saying about the adaptive ones, yes. So this which I call the responsible autonomy, yes, is the one which can respond in the best way to these ambiguous problems, more complex problems, and also the modular network. So there are a few kinds of DAOs and networks which we can figure out how to design in order to contain the complex crisis. That previous image, I can go in depth with it if you can go previous. Yes. So this is, I worked actually with emergency responders because they are the most top-down hierarchical organization. So I worked with them to decentralize them. So, and I can tell you more on the conference days how I did that. And actually, you know, the idea is that we can coordinate over distributed agents which do not have apparently any connection because, yes, we can communicate indirectly. Just like the individual ant cannot have any idea that the shortest path from the nest to the food would be this one. It's like there is some magic hand here coordinating every ant. But among each other, with coordination, they can find the shortest way. And we can also implement that. This is mathematically, of course, encapsulated. It can be done in software, and then we can coordinate across DAOs, across people, and create the platforms that can implement coordination. So the idea of organic governance is what I was mentioning to you, yes? So let's move away from the Moloch paradigm, from nature as commodity to us as an integrated ecosystem into nature. The same for money, from speculative extraction and exclusive to the intentional inclusive society and system. And of course, technologically, from the monopoly power abuse of the Facebooks and Googles to empowering accountable participation. And how do we do that? Yes, so one way in which it's already done. For example, in Europe, I do not know. So I took this example about Europe. I don't know if you are aware of this. But the landowners, the land managers, are more important now than the politicians in Brussels when it comes to certain policies and decision-making, because they are the ones who actually know the conditions on the ground, and like about the weather, what are their hardships, and so on and so forth. So they are now at the top and guiding the policy through their national legislators and so on, and they dictate in Brussels. I can tell you more again in the details. So the idea that is the organic governance. So the individual actually is the one who decides, and then these local country managers, they are presenting it to Brussels, and there is this big network that emerges where we have the institutional norms in Brussels, which are actually decided by the individual agents' interactions. And so just to conclude, and Rob mentioned this, belonging and other autonomy and so on, other capacities which we need to build. And if you come tonight to our sharing ceremony, this is what we are trying to enable you to experience. How do we develop that capacity? Those capacities, actually, yes, belonging, autonomy, collaboration. How do we develop that? Not to be afraid that, okay, if I collaborate with this person, they're going to compete with me and take this stuff from me, and so on and so forth. So we are looking at this organization 3.0. And there is a wonderful book by Desmond Tutu, Al Gore, and so on, which is called Imaginal Cells. You can Google it. It's wonderful. I will talk about it if you choose that I give an in-depth workshop on the last day. Let's move on now to the next slide. Just this one. So there are different ways to implement this. And these are the future archetypes. This is from the trilogy, Future Humans. You can Google it. There are three books, wonderful books. So Wholeness Coder, Future Creative, Evolutionary Catalyst, Pattern Weaver. These are just some, but we can invent many more. And of course, properties like originality, inspiration, courage. These are the capacities, trust, love, commitment, creativity, wisdom. These are the capacities which we need to develop individually. So that's what the future human will embody, who can actually implement that world which we are dreaming about. And now we can just move on. Yes. Just one thing I wanted to say. Yeah, this architecture is politics. The cultural shift is very difficult. So, you know, just not to minimize that, okay, we got it, and everyone else will get it. Most people are here, yes, they grew up here with this mental cast, and many times I find myself, yes, coming from here. So the idea is if the hierarchy goes to the network and says, you know, take me to your leader. I want to tell the leaders. The network would say, which leader? We don't have any leaders. We decide together. So there is a miscommunication between them. So we have to find a way somehow, and hopefully we will together, just the one before. And if the network goes to the hierarchy also, they can say, let's do this. And they say, oh, on whose authorization? We cannot do this. And then, of course, the network will get forgiveness later, so let's just do it. And this is us. These are the people. I will talk about principles of emergent engineering on the last day, if you want, if you will vote for my workshop I'm advertising. Let's go on now until, just move. This is what you will see on the last day, just so you see what you will be missing. So the idea is, how do we create this adhocracies, this socio-technical combinatorics, the platforms that would enable us to cluster together? And this is one example. It's which is enabling us through an app, a shift from centralized hierarchical control to awareness-based decision action. And it's called Open Litter Map. I don't know if many of you have found it or are using this Open Litter Map.
They got rejected by Bitcoin.
I know, but they got accepted by Cardano, so by Cardano Catalyst. So, and they were. But thank you for knowing about them. I am actually I love Sean Lynch, who is the founder. I'm just like, you know, like with my soul, of course. It's an amazing project, and he was fighting for it for a long time. And so anyway, so the idea is, for those who don't know the project, so everybody can download the app and photograph litter, and then if there is enough in a certain area, region, then they can summon the cleaning mob, the impact mob, however you want to call it, and they can get tools. Oh, you cannot see much. This is supposed to be a map with litter, but okay. and they can get tools from their town hall and so on and so forth, but we can also get, and this is a publication, a scientific publication together with UCL, we can get a map of all what's happening in the world, how much pollution in terms of litter is there, how much plastic pollution, and so on and so forth. So this is a project which can have an enormous impact at scale if we all download the app and go on for it. There are many more projects go on, and I can tell you about them on Saturday, and just go on until I tell you to stop. And here, unfortunately, this is not working. We tried, but I hope you will find it. If you go to sustainableada.com, and this is a Cardano impact report, which contains 300 boots on the ground projects that are featured there, and where you can find a lot of like-minded thinkers. As a strategic impact leader for the Cardano, I've been working very closely with the community and publishing this 300-page report. I've been helping them a lot on that. So please, you will find many. So let's build this future together. Reach for the star to get to the moon, as we crypto guys are aiming at. Thank you.
Wow.